All right, a while back, a very nice Redditor, whose name will appear here, something to do with breakfast cereal, gifted me these AKG K240s and a picture of the Space Mongoose. And he's been begging me to do a review, and I've been completely not doing it, and I apologize. But now it's the day. Now today is the day. Headphone recorder is semi-ready. We'll give it a test run. Here's your box. There was your box. It's got a couple bullet points. Everything claims it's very professional, semi-open. Where are we made? It's made in China. It's a Harman International company. Blah, 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 blah. This guy looks real happy. There's things and stuff. Right now, onto the actual headphones. The connector on it is a mini XLR, which is nice, except really hard to replace just on your own. This was just a quarter inch or eighth inch, it would be a lot simpler. But it is secure. Again, if it was eighth inch, it would just yank out instead of breaking. This will certainly break before it yanks out. They're gold. They got a little bit of gold to them. A little gold finger going on. They're light. I mean, like, if you leave these on a car, they're going to blow away. And, of course, they come with a 25-foot cord, or whatever the hell it says. 13? Is it meters? Is it 3 meters? But it's a long, 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 long cord. And I'm sure you could order a shorter one, but it doesn't come with. It comes with a long, long one. It also does not have an adjustable headband. It's just all spring-loaded. Actually, look, it's got like little freaking, they're not bungees, they're like strings on pulleys, and there's like a reel system in there. So that's pretty crazy. And these are the first pair of AKGs I've owned, because I now own them. And you can't take that away from me, ever. And so they're light. They have that rotation around the collar bit going on there. And as long as your head fits in the parameters of that wide or that wide, they're pretty darn comfortable. And as big as these are, and you know, nice they twist. As big as these are, they're still not, you know, 3 knuckles big enough to fit your ear. So your earlobe's under here, and you're getting a bit of rubbing here. And the guy who gave me broke them in for like, I don't know, 3 years. So I'm assuming they're not gonna have any characteristics change from the listing I have done. Actually, wow, look at that. You could see, because I had them resting on the recorder for a while, you can actually see where it's gonna touch your ear. So here's the lobe, there's the back of the ear, and there's the top, because you don't want to ever have you don't have a front of your ear. So there it is, there's the lines. That's sort of cool. Now, because they're so light, it's not super clampy. They definitely have clamp. They feel alright. They do make a weird wrapping paper crunchy sound when they settle, and then that goes away. If you move your, if you move your jaw, you could hear it sort of upsetting things. Now, I have 2 things here that I'm going to be playing these through. I've got my Audio Engine D1, which I have just put a review up on, which we got to turn on, and it'll take over from that. Click. And now this is playing. Now, let me switch through some tracks with shuffle on, preferably. Shuffle tracks. Shuffle harder. Am I in some weird folder of just this dude? There we go, maybe I was. Whoa, what the hell was that? Just had a weird static explosion. It had to be from this. We'll assume that's never going to happen again. 28 weeks later. Prometheus. Now, with everything up there, and it's plugged in, they're pretty loud. I will give them that they're, come on. I never play. Wow, I have a lot of quiet music on here. There we go. Nice and loud there. So, this is at maximum. We're maximum windows, maximum on this Audio Engine D1 that's USB powered only. And I'd say it's just at the peak of how loud I'd want a headphone. And that said, that means they're pretty inefficient. They are not going to work well on your phone. Because this is, I think, more powerful than your phone's going to be able to put out. So, as long as you're okay with that, then these are fine. But if you do play quiet music, which apparently I play tons of quiet music, that these are going to need more power. So, I've arranged for more power in the form of the O2 amp, which I'm going to use upside down because it just works better in this situation. So there's an upside down O2, which will, of course, is a goddamn disaster to hook up because NWAV guy may have been a genius, but he was that kind of genius that like sleeps with tissue boxes on his feet and designed everything to come out the front. And then there's a UK company that has an O2 that's actually got rear USBs and everything. Well, that's for the ODAC. But now we're on. We're in low gain mode. Tracks are changing. And this output controls the output of the RCAs, which is going into the O2, which is power from the transformer. We're using a sum total of 1 watt. Let's put these on and raise the volume. Yeah, on the low gain setting of an O2, absolute full volume on this is loud, like officially loud. Like I don't need to think you need to use the high gain setting. Here's the high gain setting. Yeah, that's way loud. Okay. So, the output of this headphone amp, the D1, is just the line of good enough, and the low gain setting of the O2 is above where you'd need it. So work out some maths on what kind of power these require to be used, because it's right up there. If you have these, you probably need an amp for them. I'd love to have my E10 here and give that a whirl too. Alright, how do they sound? Let me breathe it in for a minute. It's been a while since I wore these. Things are very... Semi-open is good for soundstage. And for those of you who don't know what soundstage is, it's where instrument A sounds like it's here, and instrument B sounds like it's here, instead of here in my ears, or dead in the center. So there is a space. They are bass anemic to the point where I think something's wrong. And I've asked him, and he said, no, that's exactly what they are. They're a little... I've looked up other reviews, and the low end is sort of not there. But, you know, I'm not... Some people don't like bass in their headphones, and these are your headphones. If you like a really neutral... It's not neutral. There is a curve here. I think it looks like this. No bass. Bass, like in the 150 hertz range, is a little peak. And then it sort of like dances away into the highs. The highs are sharp and clear. Not murderously sharp like grottos. God, the worst things ever are coming up. Die Hard 5 soundtrack. How could I have a soundtrack to a movie that shouldn't have ever existed? Oh, there you go. Michael frickin' Jackson. I'm sure that's gonna get pulled just from that little bit. Well, there you go. I just sold them because if I'm singing and dancing to Michael Jackson on a review, obviously they're good enough to sing and dance to Michael Jackson on a review. And that's just sales right there. Let me actually check something, because I want to put on, if it's not on already. And I don't even have it installed. I suck. The Bauer binaural enhancement. So I'm playing these raw right now, which is not how I usually like headphones. But for this first test, it's fine.
grinner.
Alright, let's give the recorder a try. I'm going to stop all this, move things, and I'll be right back. Alrighty. HM5's on, plugged into the Zoom. We've got these positioned properly. I'm hitting record. And hopefully I'm reversing that because I have the microphones in the wrong ears. Don't talk to me about that. I'll fix it in post. Now, I believe my leveling is good. I believe my seal is good. I'm dubbing this entirely over through the microphone, which you're probably hearing right now. I'll touch the... That weird to hear me do that. Levels are good. Let's random a song. Well, the bass is actually pretty... Bass is pretty good. I'm gonna mix some of this microphone in too. Bass is pretty good through this rig. Might be a slightly exaggerated thing because of the shape of it. Am I good? My headphone test track is not on here. It sucked. Disney will come and castrate me if I play the Aladdin soundtrack.
They brought us out of Africa to these foreign lands, put us in a gilded cage, held us in their hands.
Oop. Probably shouldn't knock on the table. Sounds pretty good. It's worked out real well with the way I've insulated it. Alright. One or two. It's my father's recording of the wall or the doors or something. That's a Tascam recorder of a live band being played back in FLAC through an Audio Engine D1's DAC, powered by an O2 headphone amp through AKG K240s into a custom binaural stereo rig through Zoom H1s, then compressed and streamed over YouTube to you. And that's about the quality you should expect. Ooh. Crunchy sounds. So the good parts. Is not who you want to play. Tim Martinez.
What other archaic rituals are you people forbidden to take part in?
What?
Like, for instance, what if we were to walk into the saloon here, sit down at a table, order a drink, and drink it? Would the authorities frown on that?
Hell yeah, they're gonna frown.
And what part would they find the most offensive?
Oh.
Vocals. I may need to find a very severe... find some really good singing. Why
can't I never met a girl who made me feel the way that you do. You're all right. Whenever I'm asked to make my dreams real, I tell them you do. You're out of sight. I'm talking to you, come on.
Not really vocals.
Shout, shout, let it all out. These are the things I can do without. Come on. I'm talking to you, come on.
When I was 17, when I was 21, it was a very it was a very good year for city girls who lived up the stair.
Come true. I see if I can turn the low cut.
When you wish upon a star,
might be a little more accurate.
Makes no difference who you are, anything your heart desires will come to you. See the lights go out on Broadway.
Low cut filter has to be off, and you get a little bit more of a sense of what it's like. It's way too bass on emphasized because of the design. It's just vibrating into those ears, and it's playing abnormally bassy through these. I know if my HM5s are displaying too much bass, then this is what it should sound like. What I'm hearing here is what it should sound like when you listen to this at home through YouTube. Well, a little bit better here, but... So, I'm trying to get these to sound exactly like these do, which is going to involve... a little bit of movement, a little bit of tweaking. Definitely a bass cut on this. But yeah, I'd say it's a successful test regardless of this. These headphones, which I'm putting on my recommendations list, which will be added to the description of this video. These are good. They're light. I mean, super light. You can't really travel with them. There's no folding at all. Like, at least the HM5s, you could sort of squeeze down into a tiny little package. Like a little tiny package. Where these are just gonna be big, bulky things. You gotta either put them around your neck or carry a big bag. So, do these get a recommendation? Absolutely. If you don't like bass, if you're one of those people who's not a bass head and wants just clear highs, decent soundstage, semi-open, which means you could actually still hear the world. You probably hear me talking through there. And they're your go-to babies. Around the same price are the, I wouldn't even say little cousins. I'm going to say genetically cloned NVX XPT100s, which I had these at home. And then I bought the XPT100s, which are essentially just these with a different brand and a much, much looser clamp. And those are my everydays. These are my special occasion. These are my monitoring. I want them real clamped. I want to just hear what's going on inside the headphone. Than these. But it's either these or NVXs. You're either going with open or completely closed. I will think the NVXs are way more comfortable. Because they simply fit your ear a little better. The cup shape is, I wouldn't say more standard. But certainly ovaled compared to the... what is very, very, very round. Also, there's very thick padding in here that I'm just noticing. This is like 1/8 inch thick padding, which I'm sure if you modified would change things, but not for the better, because I wouldn't want any more highs coming through than they already do. So, K240 AKGs. They got a thumbs up, just not for bass heads.